trip up to Edinburgh. There was a friend at Edinburgh University at the end of the last term. And the train got delayed for 2 hours. And we love a complaint. Everyone loves a nice complaint. But it's the best when you're in the right. It's like a guaranteed win. You can't say the train wasn't delayed. And it was great because there were all these old Scottish people in the same carriage. And until there was a delay, they hadn't moved at all. But the moment they had a reason to complain, they were getting ready. All the women stretching. Limbering up for a really good complaint. Oh, I'm going to have such a good complaint. This ancient man in the fat cap doing lunges at the door. And I had a lot of time to think in those 2 hours. And the Scottish are clever. They've given us the TV, the telephone, and the fridge. And I realized that when they invented the fridge in Scotland, they had to go elsewhere to find a market for it. The man's in a conversation. Hamish! I've invented something. What is it? It's a box. It's a special box. What's it do? Keeps some cold. And you're going to sell them, eh? You want me to buy a small cold box? Eh? My house is a small cold box! I don't need a small cold box. What's it for? Your food. My food? I need a small hot box! It's an oven! I think you know when you're grown up when you can enjoy complaining. Children don't enjoy complaining, but one of the other ways I knew I was grown up when I was literally grown up, like I stopped growing, when your parents would have marked your height on the door frame, and it's the day that you go there and it hasn't moved. Oh. You feel like you failed. Your parents suddenly become like really tough New York agents. You're lost again, you're in that man. Your baby sister, she had 2 inches last month. You're done. I have a new favorite word. Airport. Because it's like someone's trying to explain the future to a pirate. Airport. I saw a really good advert during the holidays. It was so good that I had to write down what the woman said. It opens up with, like, you know, the classic woman, the voiceover, little airbrushed, and she's going, "What is it that you first notice about me? I'm interested, you know. Is it my eyes? You know, close up with the eyes, looking good. Is it my saucy tango moves?" And she's doing, "That's not tango." I can't. It's not that easy. And then the next thing she said was, "I bet it's not my weak bladder control." What about that? How would I tell? And I realized that adverts are very sexist. You can't have a woman in a suit in an advert unless she's got something wrong with her organs. A woman in a suit walking down the road is just like going, "Ooh!" It's one of four things. Period pains. Constipation, diarrhea, or bloating. She's slowly inflating. And that's cured by yogurt. Made up bacteria. And she'll take the medicine and it'll be really easy. And the second she takes it, she'll go. And then the next clip is of her enjoying, in a suit still, she's still in a suit, enjoying a film with her friend. "You're going to work a minute ago!" "Well, I've already called in sick, might as well just Skype the whole day." I'm very bad at names. There are people I've known in my college, because I just never introduced myself, I never took a chance in the first week. And you get awkward social situations out of that. Like, there was one person who tried to talk to me in a crowd a few weeks ago, and to avoid them, I literally went, "Oh yeah, oh, what's up, guys?" And I turned around, and because it was crowded, I just went, I knelt down, and I knew that the crowd would make it look like I was gone. And they turned around again, and I said, "Don't, I can't explain this." And they thought, "Oh, he must have gone," and they walked away, and I just went, Flint, but ancient Flint. And someone said, that's got all the bells and whistles on. I said, no. It hasn't got any. And that phrase irritates me, because most phrases have got like a history, like you can explain it, like the locking the stable door after the horse is already bolted. That's, you know, that's logical. Bells and whistles? Is it not like in the 1800s someone was going around with a giant bell with little whistles all over it, going, see what I bought? I recently figured this out though, it doesn't ruin the joke, but I'm leaving with the fact that I did find something which has got bells and whistles in it. It's a jester and a life jacket. That's it.